We all know Gary Vaynerchuk. And as you're talking, yeah. I'm thinking about him. Gary Vaynerchuk, his thought philosophy is put the content out there. There's never too much content. I don't care if you drop a piece of content an hour. That is still like a raindrop in the Indian Ocean.
Yeah.
Is that your philosophy as well? Or is there such thing as overkill, being in your potential fans' faces just a little too much?
I don't apply that philosophy for everything that I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
But when I'm, especially now, just as an entrepreneur, I'm building a lot of back-end infrastructure. So I had to take away from a lot of, you know, like social and things like that. But when I'm talking, when all is said and done and certain infrastructure is in place, I'm all about, let's get out there, stay out there as much as possible. I don't really believe in the saturation. If you have enough depth to you, right? And that's what the thing is, right? Sometimes you might be young and not, and it depends on your subject matter, all that stuff, but you might not have enough depth within your category or just in who you are just yet, or how your ability to display it for people to care that long. But even bigger than that, there's a reality that everybody doesn't know who you are, right? So somebody else can experience you next year and I get tired of you, I opt out, right? I've watched plenty of Gary Vee videos and, you know, I opt out at times. I might go 6 months, a year without seeing a video from him, but he's not worried about that because he keeps doing what he's doing. And he already knows the reality of somebody's always going to come, somebody's always going to go. The whole name of the game is to grow so you don't have to hurt when that happens, right? And a lot of people spend a lot of time trying to hold on to, you know, the fans that they have, the level of engagement they have at any given moment. But if you keep going, there's this long tail. Number one, like Gary Vee gets positioned as this maybe creative or just surface level motivational a lot of times. But if you hear the things he's saying, they're all basic science, right? Like he says at bats a lot, right? Look, if I post more times numerically, I do have a bigger chance, right? Mm-hmm. Of course, you want to apply some strategy and not post somewhere that has, you know, no attention or something like that. But he says that strategically. All right, where's the attention? Where's the cheapest attention at the time? All right. And then even if you look at his model, to be honest, I feel like a lot of people miss the fact that he doesn't have to do the manual posting. He's just walking around being him and they're recording it. But the philosophy of the numbers game, look, he did it. Future did it, right? Gucci Mane did it, like flooding the streets. Like there's so many examples of volume actually working out in your favor. It's just, when does the volume and talent and awareness meet? Because sometimes people are doing volume, but maybe that volume is just getting your reps so you can more quickly be good enough, right? And then after that, yeah, once the awareness hits, you have a lightning rod, right? Lightning strikes. You see this one thing that blows up. And now everybody's in my brand. I didn't post for like 8 months straight on YouTube.
Me and you personally?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, all 2020, we were focused primarily on just back-end business structure, growing the agency, getting certain operations in place. Because I understand, and I really ran into this understanding from the tech world first, just like, because being a part of startups and growing stuff fast, when shit grows, especially quickly, things break, right? Systems, processes break. The name of the game is to have enough system and have enough confidence where when stuff breaks, you have the ability to fix it without slowing down too much or, you know, getting knocked out. So we were building a lot of that back end so we can be prepared to, like I said, go more of the Gary Vee where, okay, I could be out there again and again. But nah, man, people, that oversaturation is more of a personal insecurity that people find more than anything, because people are always going to go through their love and hate or hot and cold moments with even their favorite stars. Like, you don't listen to your favorite people every day, you know,
I'm just talking about just from the concept, because I try to ask questions that I think our audience would want to know. Is somebody right now, and just for clarity's sake, I started in music industry, I branched out, and most of the marketing we've done over, I don't know, the past 10, 15 years is with corporate brands.
Okay.
You brand yourself, Sean Taylor, brand man, music marketing maverick. So I'm going to stick for this conversation, if you don't mind, to music marketing and breaking artists, because I know that's your sweet spot. That's the area that you're most comfortable in. And I don't want to put words in your mouth. But I try to ask these questions because there's a kid out there somewhere, middle America, who is trying to do everything that they know how to do to be noticed. And truth be told, there is not a platform that's out there that is not oversaturated at this time. So when I ask, is there a such thing as too much content? You know, I'm looking for the answer you just gave. In some cases, no, absolutely not. But it has to be a place where the marketing and the talent merge.
Yeah.
Something
to consider too is just, well, especially if you're talking about artists, I think influencers in general face it, but I talk to a lot of artists who are so busy about oversaturating their 1,000 followers, 200 followers, you know? And it's like, yo, there's so much more world out there. Like, you can't worry about these people. If these people stay or if they don't, that's why growth is the answer. Just every business has to grow every year. You have to be able to grow so you're not worried or resenting those people who are currently following you if they don't happen to follow you in the future. Because nobody's going to be there always. But yeah, you like that. That's really the answer. Like you said, the talent and everything merging, but also the consistent growth and looking to find new people. You have to always have a new people program, and you have to have a retention program. But especially when you're a certain size, you can't even think about, you can't afford to think about retention, to be honest. You got to be like, yo, I'm trying to get it seen by as many as possible.
You know, it's so interesting, and I love this conversation, because your philosophy is the yin to the yang of so many other traditional marketers. Traditional marketers will tell you, pay close attention to those 10 people, those 100 people, those 1,000 people that are your core fan base. Those are the people you want to feed. You want to keep going. And if I'm hearing you correct, you're saying, yeah, retention. You want to give that core 100, core 1,000, all of the attention in the world, but you need to be focused on that next 1,000 and the 1,000 after that. Is that correct?
You have to. Otherwise, like I said, man, if it's not growing, it's going the other direction, because you can only get so much from your fan, your current fans. And shoot, they might start to resent you if you have to keep going to them for money, right? Like you can provide better services, just like certain clients and things. It's like, yo, man, it's not worth me working for you for this much, but I can work for you at this much, and I can give you better service here. I can pay more people and make sure they're, you know, paying attention to certain details, and everybody's happy. The better your experiences are, the more fans that you have, the better experiences overall that you can give fans, right? Travis Scott, because he has so many fans, he can do stuff like the video game Fortnite and things. He can do the crazy stages and all those things. If he only had 500 fans, he wouldn't even have the ability to do that. So, like, it benefits everybody in the long term, but if especially early on, the muscle of growth versus retention, they're very different mindsets, and it's hard to click and switch back and forth, to be honest. So you have to, if you have to opt for one, opt for growth, right? And then when you have enough growth, if you're having trouble switching back, find somebody who can pay attention to the retention, you know what I mean, and handle that. But of course, they're both extremely important, but it's it's like making money versus saving money, right? You know, a lot of people grow up, unfortunately, without a mentality or understanding of savings, but then the next level up, a lot of people figure out saving, you know what I mean? But you can only save what you make. You get what I'm saying?
Correct.
Oh, that's the tier. You know, you got to know how to make and then save what you make. And that's what I look at retention and new fan generation as.
What's up, guys? Thanks for sticking with me to the end of the video. Truly appreciate you. If you like anything you heard here today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you know anybody that can benefit from this message, feel free to share. Peace and love.